All right, this is gonna be a quick one. I got a question from our colleague Carl regarding the daylight factor. Carl wrote, thanks for great tutorials. Would really appreciate if you could go through the honeybee daylight factor. I certainly can now. As you can remember from the previous videos, we built the honeybee model with the honeybee tools, and then we walked, and then I walked you through some of these tools here, and we actually pretty much covered most of it. And we did the annual daylight study, the point in time grid-based study, and we haven't done yet all the image-based analysis. And also not all of these here, but there's one. It's called the Honeybee Daylight Factor, and it's I can show you very quickly how that works, and we can remove some of this here first. So we set up the rooms, we added apertures and shading, we add a function to rotate our model if we need to, and then we added a grid to our model and visualized the wireframe, and then we did the study. And for now, I don't need all these things here, it's way too much. I'll keep only certain items. I keep this one, the grid selection. I don't need the annual daylight study. I don't need well, I keep these things in here. It doesn't hurt, but I disconnect everything. So these are just things I can reuse if I want to. So I don't need any more. This I don't. That was if we want to check like one specific point or points. Keep this, and we keep. We don't need this one anymore. So I also remove this because we don't need that. So. Ignore it for a minute. Yeah, also this one. Don't need that. This was our room selector where we selected which room we want to test. And here we just got the mesh from where we select the mesh we want to use. Please check the previous videos if you're not clear about that. Daylight factor. Daylight factor, I would suggest to just remain with the current set, the current modifier set, or have your own materials applied. That's also possible. But make sure that you understand that there are two generic modifier sets. One is for solar radiation study, and one is for the visible light. The daylight factor is basically geared towards checking the daylight in order how useful it is in your how much you have in your room and so on. The daylight factor is basically trying to give you an idea on how good is your room lit. Actually, it's all written here. Run a daylight factor study for a honeybee model. Daylight factor is defined as the ratio of the indoor daylight illuminance to the outdoor illuminance on an unobstructed overcast sky. It is expressed as a percentage between 0 and 100. So it's basically, if you imagine an overcast sky where the light is very well distributed over the whole hemisphere and lits your object from all sides very evenly, then that's basically the model for this study. And you get pretty much like the same amount of light from all sides. Then it gives you analysis will then tell you the percentage of how much light in comparison is distributed inside your room. I hope I explained it correctly. So let's read it again. The daylight factor is defined as the ratio of the interior daylight illuminance to the outdoor illuminance under an unobstructed overcast sky. Illuminance, by the way, is the amount of light which an object receives. It's not the amount of light which is coming out of a light source. It's basically how much light is an object receives. So therefore, it would be a good idea to also think about your materials. There's more actually to it. So because daylight factor is computed using an overcast sky, it does not change with north, east, south, west. As such, it is more suited to assessing daylight in climates where cloudy conditions are common. Okay, let's go further here. The honeybee annual daylight recipe yields a much more accurate assessment of daylight, and it's suitable for all climates, though it requires a significantly longer calculation time than daylight factor. So that's one reason if you don't have enough time and you want want to just check different, very quickly, different options, window size and so on, then the daylight factor might be very useful for you. We don't need any weather data. We just need the model, because the light source, it's pretty much the same from everywhere. So the analysis assumes that there is light coming from all sides in the same quantity. And therefore, we don't need any other weather data or sky or any of these tools. We just need to apply the model. So we get the model from here. And please check the previous video so you know what I'm talking about. We need the run toggle. Boolean toggle, sorry. Boolean toggle. And we want to select the right room with the grid filter. So the grid filter, if we apply the room, then it will select the correct grid from the model. As you can remember, we set grids for each room. Each room has a grid applied in the model. So that's basically here. And then we feed the model with the grid into our analysis tool. And then with the name of the room, we can then select or filter the grid. Selected here, level one. And here is level one, one. This is the room, the first room, the bigger room here. We also need to select the correct mesh for that. So we want to select the mesh for this room. So the correct mesh where the points are applied. And we can get that with this tool. Get grids and views from the model. And then we have the mesh. And that we also need to select the correct one. And it's the first one in the list, so that's why it's zero here. We feed that into the mesh. The results, they go into here. As you can remember, I set this up with in between data container, because I want to be able to flatten or unflatten without the calculation to run again. So anything comes out here, I can flatten, and that goes into the heat map. Or of course you can always look at the results in the list, or as I showed last time with these tools. Yeah, then we can just run the script. Daylight factor. Because we only have also only one window with quite large window frames here. We also don't have so much light in comparison to the outdoor illuminance. So it's basically around 10% here on the peak value is around 10% of what is outdoor. We could also use select a different room, maybe with more windows. Let's do that. Let's select this one. So we could let's stop this calculation. We go into the second room. Oh, and here we select level two. So now it should. Now we can calculate again. Yeah, it looks quite different, but you can actually see not so much light is going in because they are smaller, these windows. Let's reduce these window blinds here, or the border shades. I don't know why they're so big. Yeah, they make a big difference. So now from 2%, it almost went to 9%. We could also maybe remove the shades entirely. We just keep the border shades, but we remove these shades here, these vertical shades. Just jump over here. We don't need that. Hasn't changed much really. The question now is, I'm not sure what is a good value for this. And the output is percentage. Actually, let's read what's in here in the output. The daylight factor values from the simulation in percent. Daylight factor values from the simulation in percent. Each value is for a different sensor of the grid. This can be plugged into a Ladybug special heat map component along with meshes of the sensor grids to visualize the result. Okay, and you can see all the values here. Now we need to first to know what is good lit and what is not. I found a website. I mean, there are a lot of different descriptions, of course, but this talks a bit about what I would be interested in as a designer is about the daylight factor and how it's actually perceived. And here is a very simple description. It says rooms with an average daylight factor of 2% are considered daylit. However, a room is only perceived as well daylit when the daylight factor is above 5%. Daylight factors are always measured under the overcast sky in an artificial or in an artificial sky, which simulates a standard CIE overcast sky. And here are some numbers. Room appears strongly daily if it's above 5%. So it seems like that we have a pretty well lit room, or let's say certain areas in the room are very well lit, others are not. So we could, if you want to look at that a bit closer, so here it says daylight around 4% would be ideal. So around the between five and four would be ideal. We could make this a bit more clear with the legend parameters. What I want to do is I want to set the minimum and maximum so I can look at a bit more detailed and what is what. Let's set the minimum to 0 and the maximum. 100% is a bit strange because we will not see much, it's all within here. Let's say 10% so we get a good feeling and we see it more clear on what is around the right zone. So ideally the areas with which are within 4 and 5, these are the areas which are well lit, or let's say the areas from 3 to 5. It's actually not the whole room, it's just a portion of it. And we could, therefore we could say, so now we look at everything which is good lit, and these are actually above 5. You can see it's actually higher. What is the maximum actually? We need to know the maximum. So the maximum is 10, around 10. Then we know everything which is blue is actually not well lit, and only these areas are lit properly. These areas feel very gloomy. So now you could of course start to play around with your window size, the location to even that out, or maybe you need another window, or maybe it's a thin long window on the top which lights your room more evenly. Actually, let's try that. I'm very interested. Yeah, that's better. It's a bit different, big difference. Here it becomes very dark, but then you get a bit more light here. It's almost a bit too much now. So, but yeah, I mean, it's just an example on how you could play, because it feels like that this window, which is higher up and more longer, will have a better distribution of light within your room than a window which is more square shaped and in one position. It lights the space very well here, but then further into the room it's not as well lit. So that's the daylight study. I hope that answers the question, and let me know if something is unclear or you're still not sure about how it works. It's getting late already. See you next time.